15th of Sha'ban,
Imam al-Askari salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayh sends a messenger to the house of his aunt Sayyida Hakima. Sayyida Hakima, daughter of Imam al-Jawad alayhi salam. This Sayyida Madhluma comes home. The narration mentions that this is after Salatul Maghrib. She recites the Salatul Maghrib in the house. Within this house, there used to be a Salatul Jama'ah. And what type of Salatul Jama'ah? Where the Imam is Imam al-Askari. And from the Ma'muneen of the house, you have the likes of Sayyida Narjis and Sayyida Hakima. Imam calls home Sayyida Hakima. And after Salatul Maghrib, he says to her, O aunt, at the time of Suhoor, yani just before the time of Fajr, is going to be the birth of the Hujjah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on earth. Alladhi yuhyi al-ard ba'da mawtiha, who will give life to the earth after its death. What is meant by life and death of earth? The death of the earth, yani the earth is filled with kufr and filled with oppression and filled with every sort of injustice. The Imam will bring life to this earth by establishing adl, justice and haq, and putting forward the prerequisites for prosperity. And indeed, the fruits of prosperity shall bear within his imamah. Sayyida Hakima looks at Imam al-Askari and she says to him, Ya Hujjat Allah fil ard. Notice Imam al-Askari is giving glad tidings of the birth of a Hujjah. Sayyida Hakima is referring to the Imam Zaman of her time as Hujjah. She says, Ya Hujjat Allah fil ard. And who is the mother of this awaited Mahdi? He says to her, Sayyida Narjis. Sayyida Hakima looks at Imam al-Askari and she says to him, but I do not see within this lady, yani Sayyida Narjis, any signs or any symptoms of pregnancy. And Imam al-Askari says to her that indeed the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can never be prevented, even if the mushrikeen and the fara'ina and the kuffar of the entire dunya were to try and prevent the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you notice over here that the circumstances of the birth of the awaited Imam al-Hujjah were similar to the birth of Nabi Musa, which is why Imam al-Baqir draws a comparison between Imam al-Hujjah and Nabi Musa. He says, within the awaited Mahdi is the sunnah of Nabi Musa. During the time of the birth of Nabi Musa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had concealed and hidden the signs of pregnancy within the mother of Nabi Musa. This is because Fir'aun was absolutely aware of the birth of an awaited savior who would come and would clean the earth of oppression and would clean the earth of injustice. And through his message and his risala, he would be the reason of the downfall of Fir'aun. Fir'aun was absolutely aware of this fact. And for this reason, he sent out armies upon armies, household after household, killing pregnant women, cutting open their bellies with swords in order to ensure that this awaited savior is not born. And history repeats itself. Because the books of history tell us that during the time of the birth of Imam al-Hujjah, the fact that Imam al-Askari was confined in a military garrison, and within a military garrison, there was imposed upon him house arrest. Bani Abbas did everything in their power to ensure that the birth of the Mahdi would not occur. Spies, military personnel constantly looking at the house, waiting for any sign or symbol of the birth of the Mahdi, such that they can kill him. And despite all the odds, the birth of the Mahdi happens. If you contemplate over the words of Imam al-Baqir, within the sunnah of Nabi Musa, there is the sunnah of Imam al-Hujjah. Look at how Nabi Musa was able to liberate the Bani Israel from the Fir'aun of their time. The Fir'aun of the time had everything in the dunya in his power. He had the wealth, he had the authority, he had the establishment, he had armies, he had military units. Each and every aspect put in place from a materialistic, political, economic dimension to ensure that his reign would continue as an oppression. against all the odds. Ya Ikhwani, the word that we need to take home for our Iman and for our Aqeedah is this phrase, despite all the odds. Despite all the odds, Nabi Musa comes and tackles and topples, destroys an empire, an empire built by Fir'aun. The entire power of the dunya is with Fir'aun. Musa comes and destroys this empire with a single staff. How do you doubt that the Mahdi will come and destroy all the powers of materialism in this day and age with a single sword? That Allah, who gave power to Musa to bring down the throne of Fir'aun, crumbling to dust with a staff, that same Allah will ensure with a single sword the Mahdi destroys the foundations of every sort of dhulm and kufr, regardless of how advanced they think they are. Same thing with Fir'aun. He felt that there was no one more advanced than him. Leave Fir'aun, Bani Israel. If only Bani Israel had that confidence in their awaited Savior. And within that is a lesson for us. Let us not be like the ones of the Bani Israel who betrayed Musa, who doubted in Musa. Bala, apart from the aspect of ghaib, that Allah can do whatever He wants, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can make miracles to happen through the awaited Savior, just like the way miracles happen at the hands of Amir al-Mu'mineen and the Rasulullah and the previous Anbiya before them. Apart from that, misguidance in the name of Imam Sahib al-Amr. Do we not see this today? Akhi, people are being taken away. Doesn't happen we become like that Bani Israel who waited for Nabi Musa. Intidar, intidar, intidar. And Nabi Musa came, they became enemies of Nabi Musa.